In this video, I want to talk about formatting, which is one of the four areas that I focus on in academic writing. The others being research, of course, and referencing and grammar. So under formatting is one of the things that will vary depending on the writing style you're using. We have a number of writing styles. So I like to begin with APA. So APA was, of course, put forward by the American Psychological Association. So that's where the name APA comes from. And basically, writing styles is just a way of harmonizing the format, just a way of harmonizing the format. In developed countries, most students have laptops. Laptops are basic. And the internet connections are also good and affordable, so many houses are connected. So given that, many schools decided this no longer necessary for people to handwrite answers, because handwriting, when you think about it, is very tough for teachers because they have to go through very difficult handwriting. Some of us have very weird and poor handwriting. It makes it even difficult for teachers to see what you even to understand your answer. So now that we have laptops and we have internet connections, then why not just tell students to type their answers? Because when you type, we have already overcome the challenge of poor handwriting. However, if you tell people to handwrite their to type their answers, there's also that risk of people typing using different fonts, different spacing, different everything. So someone will write everything in bold. Another one will use italics. Another one will use a bigger font. Another one will use a very weird styles. So it also became necessary to harmonize these styles so that even if you're telling people to type, we can have a single format for all answers. So various organizations came up with their styles. So depending on the school the student is, the school will say all our answers will be in this format. So one of them is APA, and it's one of the most popular styles, especially for students from the US. So one of the things APA have, like we said in this section, that is the cover page. So according to APA, the cover page contents include the title of assignment. So the cover page should have the title of the assignment, should have the name of the student, the school's name, and of course the course name and code. And then you also need to include your instructor's name and the date. So before I continue, let me just emphasize that I'm talking about APA 7th edition. Remember, we have different editions. So the most current edition is APA 7, and I'm going to do this video on APA 7, strictly on APA 7. So the cover page content include the title, the name, school, course, instructor, instructors, and instructor and date. And then of course, they also have guidelines for the page numbers. So according to their guidelines, they want page numbers to be top right corner. Top right corner. And they should be in plain format. Okay, so that's another guideline. So their font, their recommended font is Times New Roman 0.12. But of course, they have permitted other styles. Like now in APA 7, they are allowing people to use Georgia. They are allowing Calibri Body. They are they're also allowing, I think it is, they are allowing, let me just confirm, Arial. But in this other format, the point might be different. Others, they require 0.11. But the default one, the most popular one, is Times New Roman 0.12. So spacing between lines, they use double spacing, which is 2.0. And then between paragraphs, they don't want any spaces, no extra spaces between paragraphs. So that is their guideline for spacing, but I'll demonstrate this shortly so that it makes more sense. So let me look at something else. So of course they also permit indentations. So for I, let me just write these indentations. We have for titles or section headers, they use none. So no title or section header should be indented. And then they also have guidelines for, let me say, for paragraphs, they use first line. So the first line of every paragraph should be indented by, the first line should be indented by half an inch, 0.5 inches. And then of course now they have another guideline for indentations for references. So references, I'm referring to the contents of the reference page. So of course they use hanging by 0.5 inches again. And then of course they have now section headings. So they also have guidelines for how their headings should look like. So headings are basically how you organize your work, because if you are talking about, let's say, effects of corruption, you may decide to break it into various parts and have a heading for every part. So headings permit you to have those categories or those sections in your paper. They permit I think five levels of headings. So level 1, level 2, level 3. So they have guidelines of how level 1 should look like, level 2 should look like, which we'll also cover. Besides that, they also on the formatting, I think I've covered indentations, I've covered spacing, headings, font, and then cover page. So let us look at an example of a cover page. So the cover page will have a title. According to APA 7th edition, the cover page should have the title. So let's say effects of COVID-19 on education. So that is the title. And then we should have a name of the student. Just write name in your case, because you don't know the name of the client you're working for. Just write their literally name. They will write their name themselves. So of course now we go to institution, and then you have course, and then you have instructor. We are saying instructor because the person teaching the course might be a professor or a mister or somebody. So instructor name, and then the date of submission. So just leave them like this. The student will fill in themselves. So there are guidelines that all this information should be centered, and then again they should start about 4 lines from the top margin. So let's skip 4 lines, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the title should start about 4 lines from the top margin. So about 4 lines, and then you push these others separated from the title by about 3 lines. So title should stand alone. So skip about 3 lines. I think those are enough. So about 3 lines away from the title, that's where you start writing these other things. So they follow each other line by line, so you don't have extra spaces between them, just 1 line at a time without having additional spaces. So 3 lines. So according to APA 7, the title should be in title case and bold. So title case means all the keywords are a caps lock. So like E, C, and E, they are all caps of this. So this is title case. And then the title should also be bold. And according to APA 7, the title should also appear on page 2. So this is a cover page. It is on its own. I've just drawn these arrows here to demonstrate. In reality, you should not have these lines, and these are necessary things in the paper. I'm just using this to demonstrate. You should not have these lines. So everything else starts on page 2. So you of course move to page 2, and when you're starting on page 2, where you're now writing your answer, also start with the title. So in the case of an essay, you'll obviously start with an introduction. However, do not label that part as introduction. Do not have a heading introduction. This heading is not supposed to be there we know that the first line is the introduction. So lose that. Just write that introduction beneath the title. We know it's the introduction. Don't label it. So for essays, you start with an introduction and then you'll go to other sections and so on. The other thing about APA is the cover, the page number. So let us try to insert the page number. So they are saying the page number should be, pages should be top right corner in plain format. So top right corner should be here. So insert page number and then top of page. You select top of page because they want it to be on top, and then select the one that is on the right, and then plain number 3. Make sure it's plain, and then pick plain number 3 because this one is the one that the page number is on the right. This one on the left, centered, and then on the right. So you pick this one to insert the page number. So the next thing is, of course, now the font. So as you've already seen that everything I've been writing is in Times New Roman for font size 12, and if you check my spacing is your 2.0, which is of course double. So that is the guideline about spacing. However, if you open your Office Word for the first time, you realize that the font here is Calibri Body 11. And then of course you might realize that the spacing is either 1 or 1.15 or 1.15. I'm not sure which one is the default one for Office, but you have now to change every time you type. Every time you type, make sure you convert everything into Times New Roman, size 12 and double spacing. But that is hectic. So what you do, you set your default settings. So head over to your menu ribbon under styles. The first option in your case might be normal if nobody has changed it yet. Mine have already changed, that's why you're seeing it's a Swanee. So come over here and then right click, say modify. So under modify, you can now rename it. Just type in your name. You can just type in your name and then you scroll down to formatting. Under formatting, select Times New Roman. And then of course, now select type in size 12. Don't bold, don't italicize, or don't underline. Go to color. So make sure the color, the font color is automatic. Of course, there are quite options. I don't know why mine is hanging. There are quite some options. Let me just write something here. There are quite some options. So don't pick on other these others. Make sure it's automatic, which is a recommended one. Of course, now this is the justification. Just leave it on the left. And then this three boxes here represent spacing. So the first one, you can see the lines are very closely packed together. So you will not pick this one because this one is single spacing. This one is 1.5, which is the midway between single and double. And then this one is double spacing. So make sure you select double spacing. And then these two boxes here represent spaces between paragraphs. So this one, like you can see, the arrows are pulling away from each other. They mean there's extra spaces between paragraphs. And according to APA 7th edition, we should not have extra spaces between paragraphs. And therefore, we need to select the second option. So make sure you check on this. This is basically more or less indentation, so you do not mess with this unless somebody has messed up. So make sure you select this one. If somebody has already selected this one, return it back to this option. After you have made all those changes, you come back and confirm. So confirm you have named it appropriately, confirm that you selected Times New Roman size 12, automatic, left justification, double spacing, no spaces between paragraphs, this second option, and make sure this one is selected to this. Don't select the second one because it will ident everything. And then of course, once you confirm, come down here and select this option, new documents based on this template. If you do not select this option, the settings you've just applied here will only apply to the current document, will not be default. So selecting this option, make sure that the settings will be maintained across all documents you create in the future using Word. After you have checked this box, this option, just click OK. I will not click OK in my case because I've already set my default option. So I'll just skip that. I'll just click Cancel. So once you have the settings ready, once you have everything set, now you already on Times New Roman size 12, double spacing and all that. The good thing about academic writing is that most writing styles, including APA and the others that we'll cover, they all use the same. They'll all use font, the same font, same spacing. However, sometimes you might be given a question with guidelines on the font and the font size. So if there are other guidelines that conflict with APA, just follow those instructions. So now that we have covered that, I like just to demonstrate the spacing between paragraphs and of course between lines. So let me just see if I can get something online to use it to demonstrate. So I'll just pretend this is my paragraph. So let me just make it look like a paragraph. Just copy paste. So if I have two paragraphs, let me make them two paragraphs. If I have two paragraphs, indentations basically mean that the first line should be tabbed. So you can highlight all the paragraphs you have, and then you now click, you just click this option on the paragraph settings. Down below here, there's a corner here with more options. Just click and then head over to indentation. Under special, select first line, and then make sure it's by 0.5 inches. If your machine is showing these figures, the units in centimeters, then you need to convert them to inches, because I don't know how many inches make up a centimeter. I don't know, so you have to convert inches, and then just click OK. It will ident the first line. So for paragraphs, the first line is the one that is idented. It's idented by 0.5 inches. So 0.5 inches is basically this space. From here to here, this is about 0.5 inches, this space here. So that is what we are saying first line. So only the first line is idented. You can see under indentation, we have three options. You have none, first line, and hanging. So if you had a title here, let's call it effects. Of, let me say economic effects. If you had economic effects, this title, if you look, it's already identified, and we are saying titles and headings should be on none. So you make sure you delete the indentation by just clicking the backspace, or you can just go over to paragraphs and you can select none so that it's on the left margin. So this is what I mean, that titles do not have any identification. This should be not on none identification. So we have already used the first line option, which is for paragraphs, none for titles. So let us look the third option, which is hanging for references. So for references, let me just pick a reference. So if this is my reference, I'll copy it from Google Scholar. I just copy it and I'll paste it on my page. Let me just copy several of them so that they are quite like there are three or four. Just copying. So if I have these, let me just add another one so that they are. So if I have my references, this is my reference page. Obviously, it will be at the bottom of everything. So this is my reference page. So I label it references. And then my references, first of all, they need to be alphabetically arranged, which we'll cover later in another video. But since we are here, let me just say, you arrange them using the sorting tool of Word. So just click here and then you sort from A to Z. Make sure it's selected by text and then OK. It will arrange them from A to Z. And then once highlighting, just go to paragraph settings. And then under indentation, select hanging by 0.5 inches. So that is hanging by 0.5 inches. You can see the difference here is that the first line alone, only the first line is not indented. All other lines are indented. That is the difference between hanging and first line. In first line option, only the first line is indented. In hanging, only the first line is not indented. So this is very important for references. We will explain this. We'll learn about why references should be on hanging in another class, but that's the guideline for APA. So under spacing, you can see this already on double spacing because I've already set my options, my default paste options. Let me just delete this. So double spacing is basically the spaces between this line and this other line. So this is what I'm calling double spacing. You can just zoom this and maybe just demonstrate what I mean by double spacing. So double spacing is basically this space. So this space between this line and the other line, that is now double spaced. If I was to select single spacing, the lines will be closer together. So let's try single spacing, which is 1.0. So according to APA, we use double spacing between lines. And between paragraphs, we use single spacing. So this is paragraph number one, paragraph number two. Remember, even a title, the software counts this as a title, and paragraph number three. So let me just return this to double spacing, because that's what we should be having. So double spacing, you can find the option here quickly, or you can go here and under spacing, under line spacing, select double. Of course, that is a long way, but a shortcut is usually here. So double is also 2.0. Once you have this, let me now explain the spacing between paragraphs. So if this is, let me just delete this. So these are two paragraphs. How do I know they are two paragraphs? By identifying them, because identifications are the basic way of showing that a paragraph is a beginning. And then let me just zoom it so that we can see the space. So the space between this paragraph, maybe I should just highlight this by a different color maybe. So the spaces between the blue paragraph and the black paragraph, these are now the spaces between paragraphs. So according to APA, we should just continue with the same format we were using. So you can realize the space between here and here and here is still the same. So that's what we call no spaces between paragraph, no extra spaces. So if you want to see an example with spaces between paragraphs, we can just see. So let me add. So if you add, you realize this space here has increased. It's not the same as the space between these lines, and that is not how it's supposed to be. We're not supposed to have spaces between paragraphs. So let me just remove that. So this is what APA want. They don't want spaces between paragraphs. So we have already covered indentations, headings. There's a video for this. You will watch. Of course, spacing, found page numbers, cover page, and all that. So that is number one about APA. The other thing about APA, it's referencing, which we will cover in another video. So for now, make sure you set your default options and you practice creating the cover page. Practice, train yourself to see how double spacing looks like, how single spacing looks like, indentations and headings, because there's a video for this. So that's all for now.